as a born again believer, the pathway to intercourse and family building is marriage. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
And that's what you subscribe to.
Yep.
And there's no negotiating with you.
Oh no, what am I negotiating about? I get to negotiate a lot.
So there are aspects of my life that I will never reveal. That are between myself, my family.
And we became who we are because of that past and that history. Mm. We became strong women because we know who we are.
Abafundisi and all of that, I mean, I heard the audible voice of God.
It wasn't the decision.
On the third day.
That one, yeah.
Like Christ himself.
What was that about?
Yes. I don't even
so
know.
Just trust the person who was able to initiate a relationship with your husband knowingly and trust them with your life, with your kid.
A fancy restaurant in a beautiful place in South Africa. And he left you with 7,000.
Love them. Boots, babe. He's not circumcised.
I meant our sex.
I mean, okay. I already do
that.
Yes.
Will it marry what you say you're doing? Which is...
kuthiwa ngesiZulu umuhle zintokaza nentokazi emhlophe ngathi sihlabathi solwandle. Yes, did I get that right? The show is Engineer Your Life and I'm Lungelo KM. Welcome to another episode. Of course, if you clicked this, it means you've seen the thumbnail and you know who I'm sitting with today. She's an actress. She's also a musician. I recently found out that she's also into makeup, not just any makeup, but a very intensive, detailed level of makeup that not many people can go into. Angel, how are you, my darling?
Oh, good. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Thank you for finally coming.
Yay! It's been a long time coming.
No, but you're working so hard and that's good.
Yeah. It's been really hectic. Plus, yeah. Finally, a birthday month. It was 7 July, so it was pretty.
And manage to celebrity status. But
Hi guys. Yeah, it's getting there.
Yeah.
It's getting there.
Let's just get this out of the way. So ukhulekani ukushaya nini njengoba usunje?
How?
Wangpush exactly. Mesa ningabona to yena.
Yeah, no, man. No, it was like that.
Yeah.
No, I slept on sets. I was literally walking down the stairs.
Yeah.
Everybody knows.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I slept on one of those long stairs.
Yeah.
But okay, I'm getting there. I'm almost. Yeah, I'm almost there.
Yeah. Are you enjoying the role? It seems to be, of course, it has come with complete changes in your life, but are you enjoying it?
I am enjoying it. It's definitely different from the first one.
Sure.
If you remember Umkhokha, Kayeni, it was a telenovela.
Yes.
It was a series, sorry.
Yes, a drama series.
It was a drama series, 13 episodes.
So it was done. quick.
It was nice and quick, yabo. So a lot of information about the character.
Sure.
Whereas now, everything now is...
Detailed.
And now it's nice and longer and everything. J story sakhona si progress slowly.
Yeah, yeah.
So now ngiyasho ukuthi manje okay, I'm really enjoying it. I'm loving the things that are coming from the character now. I'm just like, wow, okay. It has improved a lot.
Something that has been in the media recently about you, which I found very interesting. Why is everybody so concerned about how old you are?
No, what? People are concerned.
They are so concerned. Like,
no.
I promise you. You missed that?
Yeah.
I promise you. Kunale debate of ukuthi. That roles that you are playing are not in line with your age. And I'm like, but that's what acting is.
Wait, what are you... I didn't know there was like a debate or whatever.
Yeah.
I am portraying Ishama Rosa. I'm the oldest, older than me.
Definitely,
like
definitely.
4 or 5 years older than me.
Definitely, yeah.
Wow, I didn't know that.
It's interesting though, because it means you're portraying it well if people are not able to see the difference.
Well, yes. Yeah. That's the whole idea.
That's the whole idea
you
of acting.
You sell the character as it is, not yourself.
Are you enjoying being a married woman on set?
I hate it so much. I hate it because I never got to enjoy the whole thing of being engaged and having the wedding. Like, God, what's our social deal? No, man, I broke as well.
So I know,
we missed some few steps there. How?
Yeah.
So, I don't like it.
Yeah. And since we're there, do you believe in marriage in your personal life?
Yes, definitely. Yeah. I am a born again Christian. Mm-hmm. So if you want to, you know, you have to get married first and. So I do believe in marriage. I believe it's a beautiful thing. Yeah, they always get in marriage and
so as a born again believer, the pathway to intercourse and family building is marriage. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
And that's what you subscribe to?
Yep.
And there's no negotiating with you?
Oh, no. What am I negotiating about? I get them to negotiate a lot. Even with black people back then, guys, they don't really as much as they did back then. But it was a big issue. When you saw whatever the case is, that's a bad thing for everyone. Everybody can agree on that. So whether you're a Christian or you're not a Christian or whatever you believe in, you can agree with me on this one.
Mm,
but yeah, people do what people want to do. Shame, I'm not a judge. Thank you. Living
true to your name, I guess.
There's different types of angels, but hey, I don't know. Maybe, yeah.
Perhaps let's explore that idea just a little bit. I don't want to dwell on it because today is about you. As perhaps one of the issues that we're suffering from a lot of people are depressed in relationships. A lot of people, relationships are ending.
Mm.
Many relationships perhaps don't have the unkulunkulu and the unity in them.
Yeah.
It's because people haven't committed to finding partners in a manner that we wait, we find each other spiritually, emotionally, we connect, and then finally
we can
partake in sexual intercourse and things like that.
I think a lot of young people are suffering from syndrome of lonely. They're feeling lonely.
Yeah.
And instead of trying to figure out izinto umuntu angazenza to keep themselves busy. Because umuntu obhizi, obhizi occupied ngomsebenzi and whatever it is, they ask where as I'm getting or is calling, they don't really get the chance to I feel lonely. You're too busy.
Yeah,
like a lot
is going on. Yeah.
So nginga, we have people who have so much time in their hands that they feel lonely most of the time. And ekubeni lonely wabo, they end up doing izinto prematurely because they feel lonely and they want to be loved. I understand we all want to be loved. Everybody wants to be loved and in a relationship or whatever the case is. But ungalenzi iphutha lokungena kwi relationship just because you want to be loved, ungene prematurely when you're not ready, when you have a lot of things that you need to work on yourself first, you know, even loving yourself first more. There's a lot to try and, but obviously ngeke ulinde forever. Khona into ozongena na relationship owazi ukuthi okay le na le iyangihlula. But at least ungenu aware ukuthi okay 1 or 2 or 3 usangihlula and ngiyazama. Nokuthi uzodiscover yonke into wena ngawe nje in relationship.
Rorisang Tandekiso, I don't know if you know her. She's a big TV personality. She was on SABC 1. She's also a musician.
Yes, I know.
She recently went on a podcast and she revealed that part of her virtues as a pure woman, and I'll use the word pure because that's how she described it. But when she says pure, she means she's never engaged in intercourse. She's in her 30s now.
Mm.
And she says one of the issues that she always comes across is that when she meets a guy, maybe a guy who's umshele, will say, okay, I agree, we will wait till marriage. But 3 months down the line, 6 months down the line, guy loses interest because We are ifuna lento, but ubesabekezela,
ubesabekezela. Yeah, hoping
ukuthi do you come across that with relationships you try?
Inkinga, I don't even try.
Hi, K, I'm sus.
I don't even know. So here's the thing. Here's how I was raised and here's what God said to me.
Sure.
Because we can serve the same God, but see, Asho isn't being a funny thing.
Sure.
Because Nat is a band of fine. We are designed in a very in different ways. Yeah, but when in the weakness, it's like how? So, mina, how I was raised at church was if when the husband comes or your wife comes, God is going to be the one to show you okay,
who it is.
This is your wife. And all of that, and then you act on that. Obviously, you don't want to waste this castle mundi when you already know that this person is meant to be with me. Why waste time? Because you already know. But obviously, as people, we want to know each other first and all of that. We get a few things out of the way. But gay research is you need 3 months to know a person.
Yeah, minimum.
Only three. Only three. Yes.
So after 3 months,
it's ngashatayikhale. After 3 months, it's ngakhale. And you know after 3 months, the relationship was doomed from beginning. You'll know after 3 months.
And a lot of people will know, but they're in denial.
Yes. They'll hold on and have hope. In like 3 months is all you need to know, is it going to work or not? You just need to take utando and just use your mind for once. But yeah, as I was saying, going back to this thing, as a Christian, God knows everything about you. God created you. He knows abazali bakho babengendlela umele uza kulo mndeni lo ukhulela khulele khona udlule into nodlula kuzona. So I believe ukuthi even when it comes to relationships, friends I have ingoba babeke uNkulunkulu empilweni yami, anginawo umngane mina nje owavela wabo umngane nje esikhaleni. Akekho umngane okhona okwenzile ukuthi empilweni yami ngikhona into afika nayo, khona ilesson azofika nayo, be it good or bad or painful or joyful or whatever the case is. Kanjalo ne relationship, like romantic relationships, God knows everything about you. He designed your whole life. He had it all planned out. So he knows, okay, when an angel, I have designed this lovely gentleman. I hope he's handsome. I have designed this gentleman for you. So the reason why I'm not even interested in like, wasting
it's
other
because of that conviction.
It's because of that. God was like, don't even bother in wasting your time in dating. You're not gonna find your husband there.
What if you're saying the Holy Spirit will guide you towards a husband?
The Holy Spirit told me not to date because I won't find my husband there. The whole reason for people to date in datela in so that you can get, as a Christian, I believe, you know. So if you're dating for fun, whose heart are you having fun with?
Power.
Do you get what I'm saying? Like, you can't say you're having fun with other people's hearts. That's not right. If you're dating, you should be dating because we are zufuna and you want to settle down, you want to get married. So what I'm saying is, nami mhla efika umyeni, only God can confirm ukuthi lo muntu lo obizongilandela njengamanje is actually the one. Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying. That's how I know mina as angel ukuthi this is the one. But he told me very clearly, what, you're not gonna find him in dating and going out and all of that. That's why I don't even waste time. they try, but I'm like, no.
But I mean, as you're saying that the Holy Spirit told you not to date, what if the day the Holy Spirit does bring you the husband and you feel that signal, oh, this is the person, you just don't love them?
I don't think that'll ever be the case.
Okay.
I don't think that'll ever be the case. One thing I'll tell you so far about my life is that I thought was good for me, and I thought, okay, this career is definitely the one. I can draw. My father works in construction. What I had reasons that made sense, and I went and did architecture. I hated it.
Sure, I hear you.
God said way before I did architecture, but I went to go to serious and that's it.
That's not a real job.
You know, I felt like that.
Yeah.
Until ngangena architecture, and then God made sure ukuthi ufaka umuntu ka architecture ozongifaka la ka acting. Ubabakho esebenza kuzala at that time.
Yeah.
And I'd always talk to her about, oh, I love uzala so much. I want to act in uzala. The girl kept quiet for a good 6 months.
Wow.
She kept quiet and said nothing, and then she tells me one day, she's like, you know, Angel, my father actually works Kaguzal. I'm like, what? The next day I was an extra. I fell in love with that job, and at the, what I'm saying is God knew Ogozi, this is what I've called you for.
And
I want
where
you to
your
stand.
Heart is.
This is where your heart is going to be. So yes. He definitely cannot bring me a person that I'm not going to love. I can guarantee you on that one. There's no way. Mm. Oh God, Daibo, no ways. But yeah, I don't think that will ever be the case. Sometimes it's in the vela nkulunkulu sinakhukulwa nazo, and then when you start doing them, and then you realize, shucks, this thing I'm actually called for, and I'm good at it without even trying so hard.
You sound very convicted with God designing your life in a certain way and you just having to stay in path for it to unfold in that way and for you to live God's purpose for your life.
Yeah.
What if God's purpose is for you to get married at 42? Are you still willing to wait till then?
Yeah. Mm. Guys, I ain't gonna give away the prize for nothing. No ways. I'm not gonna settle for less, unfortunately. It has to be standard sankulunkulu because it says your ways, his ways are higher than our ways.
Yeah,
his thoughts, imicabango yakhe. It's like yabo lo mehluko between umhlaba nesibhakabhaka. That's how high unkulunkulu asicabanga khona. So even if it's 42, uyaze ukuthi uplanele ngalowa 42, shuthi ngizobe ngisamuhleka. 42 low. Well,
I want to go into the work a bit. So as you're saying, you were studying architecture. Did you eventually complete or did you just go straight into acting?
No.
So the calling was too strong that you were like...
I didn't quit. So I didn't drop out. It wasn't me who decided, okay, nyaye, I'm not that person, Stella Sam. If I start something now, there's no way I'm going to drop. I will partner now. I did architecture. Nyawokala ngaba nemlenz. I think it was 2. Came back the following year. Ngilungisa lo mlenze leyo. Came back the following year. Ngiyakwesithathu sengenza second year manje. Ekwenzeni kwami lo second year lo ke. Hayi kuba khona omunye futhi umlenze ngoba ayi ngangayifuni architecture. I'm telling you, I hated it so much. But ngangiphasa futhi kodwa ngangayifuni. Then I came back for le mlenze u 2. No wait, no.
Guys,
I came
imlenze
back.
Is failed modules.
Failed
it's not
modules.
Legs.
You also know what that is. But anyways, I came back for second year. As I was doing in second year around June, and then I had umlenze wodwa, I think. Yeah, I had one module that was...
dribbling.
That module was not the one. Anybody who's done architecture, they can tell you ukuthi la module leya is not the one. Shame. Yo, I messed with me so much. Ngalendlela ukuthi they called it dean, the whole dean, a faculty yonke azomhlayisa phansi. But we're gonna have to take you out of the program. Ngathi how? Kubaningi. And then they were like, your group or lo nyaka wafika ngawo, you guys were the last people that benzi diploma ka architecture. So the people that come after you, benzi degree, ama modules wabo nawe nawa fan. So if you have lomlenze lo, ongesikwazi ukuqhubeka nge second semester ephansi next year, shoot, we must hire one person to teach you that.
Hectic.
Module. And I'm like,
not the system kicking you out.
They kicked me out. I was like, thank you. I walked out. I was like, yes! Because I needed a way out. My parent was paying. When as far as it was not funding anything, and I applied and they kept on being like being gap in as fast. But yeah, it's fine. So
I'm famous now.
Yes, and as far as what you gotta say? Thank you. But anyways, yeah, they kept on denying me funding. And then eventually bank kicked out at DUT when I was doing architecture leo. For a whole year. Like I was doing my gigs of music and makeup, and then bam, my first big break came for 2020 during lockdown.
I want you to us to not leave that point of and just depart from the fact that you felt that it was a big break moment. But I want you to take me just before that big break when you had lost school, you kicked out of the program in architecture. And now you're just trying a few things. What are these things that you are trying? And what lessons did you learn when you were trying? Because I'd say you were hustling. What lessons did you learn there?
I discovered something about myself I don't think I knew, because I was in a position of hustling just to make ends meet.
Sure.
You know? At that time, I don't think anyone had a job ekhaya. Or a proper job. Everyone is just piss jobs and all of that. So ngafunda lapha ukuthi yazini awukwazi ukulamba unezandla. I didn't have a qualification.
Sure.
But I had hands that can draw.
Yeah.
I need to draw somebody's face. Mm. Then that's how I started makeup. Good time, man. I need to take this seriously, you know. And then I started investing in myself. I did a lot of tapes teaching how to do it. She YouTube. So I started YouTube. tutorials and all of that. And then I was like, I sing, man. Let me do some videos. I mean, Ula, some Disney songs and whatever. And I started doing a lot of that. And obviously, gigs kept coming. And my gigs of music. Mama gigs of makeup. So that's what I was ngiphilanga lokho nje at that time. It was makeup, it was music, makeup and music. And along a pelis on Dongayanga somewhere.
Sure.
Or at least two places. So it was quite busy. I'm a fan con.
And who gave you your like one of your biggest music gigs? Or who gave you actually your first music gig?
Okay. I don't know if you remember Spelling Love from Idols.
Yes.
I think 2016, I don't know, season bar. Yes. But that's Loli, when you also yes, that's one. That's my brother, that's one.
Yes.
So Uspe, wearing my crown, got to music awards. Me and Safun discovered I was in grade 10. I was like, please go find my crown. He's like, what grade are you doing? I'm like, grade 10. He's like, oh, child, at least go to grade 12 and then we can talk. The moment I finished grade 12, I'm like, DURBAN, November. He's like, next year, my darling, because obviously I'm a crown on November now, so you guys won't get a match. So that was my first gig, music, and it was on Crown Gospel Music Awards, the biggest ever.
Yeah.
From there, kept going.
So you were a backing vocalist there?
Yes, I still am.
Really?
A backing vocalist. You know this thing of being a backing vocalist, guys? It's a pretty serious job.
And it's sustainable.
It's very sustainable.
Because I'm an artist, I'm a lead artist.
Yes.
Ne? But mo beka, unga pekela numba.
Unga pekela numba ni forever and ever. I mean, it just keeps coming. You just keep doing your job. Nji.
Yeah. And no aspirations to be a lead vocalist?
Well, eventually. I mean, people are putting so much pressure on me.
Really?
And I'm like, guys, why are you needing for any pressure? People are always like, Angel, keep her in.
Your heart is not in it yet.
Not yet.
Yeah. And that's okay.
Yeah. I mean, as a Christian, I can just send them. And that's it. You just did it and okay, fine, that's all. No. Whatever it is, oyenzayo, la ukhona, wherever God has placed you, khona impact ozoba nayo. Whether kubantu ngokuphila nje nabo kanje or your ministry, officially in my case, all the music run. So mina, my biggest fear is starting ngithi ngiyaqala music wami ovela ungathinti muntu.
I hear you. From Joyous Celebration, there was a 4 to 5 year break where Superstar, who is now a superstar, but actually doesn't take herself like a superstar because I think she's so centered in God. Claire did not release anything.
Yeah.
A lot of people were putting pressure on her. Release a single, release an album, release a single, release an album. And I remember I bumped into her. I was with a friend once, a friend who knew her.
Mm.
And she said, God hasn't given me the right album yet. You know?
Yeah.
It's not that I'm not working.
Yeah.
I'm working.
Yeah.
But the Holy Spirit hasn't given me that right album yet.
Yeah.
And where is she now? When she gave us that right album.
Exactly.
That first album, Your Kingdom on Earth, every single track in that album is absolutely amazing.
Exactly my point.
Today, she signed to an American record label and she's going to sing at the Stellars.
Yo.
Because she listened to the voice of the Holy Spirit as you sing. So I can absolutely relate to what you're saying.
Yeah, I think God's timing is perfect.
Yeah.
So I can't listen to God's timing with his and then other things and be like, nah, no.
Yeah.
I have to listen to his timing. Yeah.
So what is the big break then, now that we've built up to that point? What was that big break where you felt like, okay, this is the big break that I've got to step foot into the industry?
Okay, when acting, it was Uzalo, 2020. It was days before my birthday. I believe it was a birthday gift.
It is.
I always say, God, you gave me such a beautiful gift. But I want to act. But kissing scenes, and I'm like, Father, how are we going to balance that? Because I don't know if I can do that.
Yeah.
Smart. And then God was like, no, wait for COVID, my darling. Then, exactly. And then I got the road on Uzalo as Uzetu. Uzetu was intomazana so something
obviously. Were you auditioning for that role? Had you been trying to audition a lot for Uzalo, or how did that come about?
Angisho Uzalo, I was an extra from 2017 long university. 6 months later then I started being an extra on Uzalo for a good 3 years, I think.
Hectic.
Yeah, 2017, 2018, 2019.
So no one knows you because Jeulo bela bantaba.
Oh no, I made sure everybody knew me.
Really?
Ngingilaphayana, but akekho umuntu ongathakangazi. Because even ama actors akhona, ama engawazi ngisayi extra. Yeah. Like I knew them kanje, sikhuluma futhi into ehambayo. Ngisayi extra nginjalo.
Yes,
ukuthi
yes,
extra. Akusho ukuthi
uzophelela lapho.
Uzohlala nawe kanjena. No, make connections, talk to people, talk, and just know how to, you know, network.
I get that.
You know, so I was an extra for like good 3 years, and then days before my birthday, nje ngisahle ngithi, hey, I'm like, man, it's 21st. Manji, lockdown, Vali, we're going to Gunjan. Ah, versus Matt, no, don't worry, my child. Hank, phone call from Uzal. Hello? Angel, Ish, can you send a video? I'll send you a script. Just do this and send one video singing a song. I'm like, okay. What's going on? Then I sent this video of me singing, and then I sent the video on Gifunda script. My mom was reading Bambat. So everything that was happening on Uzal, my mom knew about. Just putting it out there. All the naughty things she knew, because we were reading the script together.
Yeah.
So that was my first big break on Uzalo. Later that day, they phoned me like, you got the character. Can you come next week, the following week, and start shooting? Then I came like,
now you're shooting at a different scale. Like, Safa Nalo got shoot go extra.
No.
All of a sudden, we won the main cast again. Jane, you're going to
be a little bit. Okay, but Funan, same reason. Yeah, but I had a few days to, you know, to enjoy.
Yes.
My character was like very small, it was a cameo. So I think some of the stars, they couldn't adjust. They were struggling because I've been an extra for 3 years. But I was about to get extra.
Sure.
So much. Yeah. Room in that lot was prioritized as well too. It's like, and I'm like,
actually, take me there in a production that's that big, that's such a powerhouse. Did you get a lot of being looked down upon when you were still an extra?
Every production.
Yeah.
Most of the production. I think it depends.
Is it from fellow crew? Is it crew members or is it cast that looks down upon you?
Well, they don't necessarily look down upon, but batles besebenza kungekho ama extras. They know how they work. They communicate. Bayazi indaba communicate ngabo bebodwa. They've built this arrangement or this life or whatever.
Trust, working relationship.
Yeah, they know a relationship yeah, and how everything works and all of that. And then kuzofika ama extras thina nkosi yami asazilutho ukuthi kwenziwani ndana. Awazi ukuthi makuthiwa mime or keep his sound emlomeni. Lapho we know what miming means, but nje. Lapho I crew is getting frustrated because they know time.
Yeah.
So I don't think it's a thing of looking down. But it's more of when there's not a lot of people around. And then when there's other people, in most cases, how it works behind the scenes and all of that. So it makes life a bit more difficult for them. That's how they get frustrated. And they don't obviously talk to ama extras the same way they'll talk to ama actors. Because with us, wakuluma nje, hey, it's a lungis her man. Fast, span bad.
Yeah.
But if it's an extra, they kind of don't have anyone to talk to at that time.
So, how long did you shoot for that role, Legazetu?
I literally shot 7 days.
Oh,
and then
man.
It played for like 3 weeks, I think. Or
It was so, that's why you didn't get to merge fully with the cast. Because you only shot for 7 days.
7 days. I don't think I created any new relationships per se. It was more of, oh, you're here. And I'm like, yeah. It's like, oh, okay, nice. And then Pele Lab. But yeah, that was that. It was great though. I really do appreciate Shemi Stained Glass for that opportunity.
Yes.
That was it for me.
And then audition time for Umkhokha, the drama series, comes, are you getting a call then? Is it your agent who hooks you up? How does that happen?
So I don't have an agent. Mm-hmm. I don't have an agent. I've never had one. Anybody that claims that I was part of their agency is lying, okay? Mm-hmm. So this is what happened prior to me getting a call to come and audition for Umkhokha. Obviously, you need an agency or Ubabgatjeni has to know you.
Yeah.
Babu Duman Dlovu, okay?
Yes.
So I had auditioned for Lion King before Kube Khona Umkhokha. I had auditioned for Lion King. It looked very promising. I think it's five out of, I don't know how many people came and auditioned. Kwasa Latina, they took pictures and all of that, but it was very promising. And obviously, Lion King, there's singing, there's dancing, there's also acting.
Mm.
So I think Bab Duma saw me there and was like, yo, I want you here.
Yes.
Ngoba wayeza wangitshela. Wathi unobusa beTV. And I'm like, yeah. What kind of a face is that? Oh, wow. Really?
Yes.
And
yes.
Then I got a call from Nonkululeko. She called me. She's like, Bab Duma said I must call you to come and audition for a new series, Umkhokha, blah, blah, blah. I'll send you everything. Would you be able to come? I'm like, yeah.
When?
When? That moment I'm in school. And in school, they're not giving us a break to do anything. Yo, ngahamba ngenkani. Besho notishu batu. Ukuyi. Ngahamba.
Yeah.
I went to the audition. At that time, I auditioned for Mabusi, actually.
Really?
The main character.
Yes.
I was auditioning for Mabusi. I went, I auditioned. It was great. So I came back the following day. Sangeniswa, I think Nonne, if I'm not mistaken. No, Masas Reheza na or something like that. Njay, everything was great. And then they were like, okay. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. And then I walked out. And then I think a week or 2 weeks later, if not 3 months, or if not a month later, because of looting. Looting 2021, around about June,
July. Yeah.
Yeah. And then they phoned and said, okay, man, this is so shooting. So we can send your video to each channel. Because the channel is the one that decides.
Ultimately.
Ukuthi who must play the main character. And there's a lot of things about big eye.
Of course. Nowadays, apart no social from, media. No, it don't.
Yes,
don't. It clouds.
It counts.
Yeah.
Apart from your talent
skill.
And your skill, then need to know Guti go social media to have impact so that even for marketing purposes, when you just post that picture, it reaches a lot of people.
They can use
you know?
It too, yeah.
But I mean, at that time, I think I had like 7,000 followers. I'm wondering what is your name, Bakichima, 40, go 100, and I'm like, yo.
It's funny you mentioned that because a lot of, I had Baby Tele on the show, the legendary Baby Tele, and she said to me, because the young actors manje are suffering where uhlala kwi audition room nomuntu na 1 million followers bani uzibona ukuthi we ngizothini nje la
bro, but I don't want them to be discouraged because here's the thing with my story. I had very little followers. I had only Uzalo as experience. The rest will be extra. I don't think it counts that much. You just know how to be on set, but actor for a camera it's a different thing. I was auditioning a character. Abanye abantu ngesingami were more suitable. I was auditioning abantu abagwimbe at that time, like full time.
Yeah.
And I think okay, hope auditioner. I think a goalie or something because when you could like as it end. And they did auditions all around. Ne? So, but abantu nganginabo were like, I was looking at them like yo. They are definitely getting this job, and I'm not. But anyways, by shooter a clip, Umondli Makoba at the time was helping me, was reading with Pamandla for me. By shooter by Hambisa, and then give it like a month or something later, I got a call from a guy, Wakona. I think we were line producer, we took Umkhokha at the time. And then he calls and says, Angel, I've called you. I have good news and bad news. I'm like, oh no. Like, this is good news. What's the good news? He's like, okay, the good news is you got a character. And I'm like, okay, great. What character? And he's like, Nomkhosi. I'm like, huh? Why didn't you know? Yes, because it's audition and there was not a character, Nomkhosi. I'm like, who's that?
Yeah.
And then he's like, okay. So because channel looks at all of these things, Konabantu had a lot of following more than you and experience the main character guys, it doesn't come easy. And if you do get a main character, God is good. But yeah, it doesn't happen like that. They need people with the experience and all of that. So and then he tells me, okay, experience and it's cameo, you know, and you haven't done anything other than that, short films or whatever, plus your following is but your acting was great. So the channel contacted, I'm a producer if I'm not mistaken, then they had to create a character.
That's God.
For me.
That's God.
To be in the show.
That's God.
That's why Nomkhosi Oqala didn't have like a character bio, because what creator on the spot, what should take, what is story.
Yeah.
And then what about Kona? Because the channel was like, okay, we want you in there,
yeah,
but we cannot give you that character because of this, this and that. So that's how I got the character. Yeah, Nomkhosi. It wasn't there, but it was created because God is like, nope.
Yeah, this is your season.
I want you there, my darling.
I think that's your big break.
That, yes. Yeah. Not actually.
Yeah.
That is my big break.
I think that's your big break.
That is my big break.
And then once again, that ends, right?
Mm.
And all of a sudden you watch Umkhokha on TV, because my name, I'm a drama series that have been on TV.
Yeah.
But for some reason, people just absolutely love Umkhokha. I'm sure you were just shocked.
I was like, what is going on?
Yeah.
No, people were insanely in love with Umkhokha. Till this very day, people will ask the whole of January, I think, because we're playing on December 2028, if I'm not mistaken, or 2021, January, February, they kept asking, when is it coming back? When is it coming back? When is it coming back? The moment ubuya. And those who knew, they're just going crazy over it.
Credit to, I'm forgetting her name, but the lady who plays Mom Zob, I think.
Unomteli.
I think she was, of course, the whole cast makes a production.
Mm.
But I think the way she executed that role to be so believable.
Right.
You guys, there's a lot of credit that Umkhokha was renewed.
Yeah.
You know, she, as a main character, as a lead,
mm,
to be so evil and make people upset and get into their emotions, that woman did an incredible job.
She did. And she's still doing an amazing job too. That's very, I'm like, hey, well, then she will get tired of being an evil person. Yo, I know. She's got it, Shem. She really got the character. She's banked the character.
Now they come back again to tell you guys it's going to be a telenovela. I'm sure that's the best news you guys have ever heard.
They told us. Really? We are Kubek Umkhokha, either as a series or it's gonna come back as a telenovela, because people are just going crazy over it. And abantu, like, if you worship Umzansi Magic, young new Umzansi Magic, apparently awazwe nama views amanga at the time. So kwafi Umkhokha, and then people started paying it on my DSTV, so that they can watch Umkhokha. And it got so many views. I think the channel was like, okay, it has to come back. People are loving it. People are watching. People are opening our channel for it. So we need viewers anyways. So when it came back, music to our ears. Music. Because it's a novella.
Because it's like a full-time job for a year. Yes. A minimum of a year.
Yeah. A whole year.
To teach yourself the skills of hustling, but to have the fears of not getting work, or
that is one is not the greatest, but it was the greatest day of our lives when we found out Ukutiyabuya, and there's few added characters, new characters, or abanye bashintshile ngoba abekho, they were shooting other things at that time, being ukuyeka and all of that. But sasibuyile and so excited about it. Yeah.
I want to move into understanding the situations that have you've gone through that have made you who you are. What is the most painful thing you think you've gone through in your life?
So, if you know me, you know that I don't have a lot of friends.
Yeah.
There's like, five. Literally only five. Now go on five. Okay, about five. I'm going to share that. I'm going to be partying. About five. I once lost a friend, one died, one moved out of a province to another. There was no way for me and her to talk. I didn't have a phone. She had a phone. I didn't have one. Yeah, bro. So I think for me, that was very painful. I know it sounds like how a friend, people have lost much closer people. At that time, the person was everything I ever needed. They gave me so much joy. They made me the person who can talk. Because I walk in the room and sit there and keep quiet. ngizengihambe futhi anginankinga. But a friend taught me how to talk. She taught me how to interact with people, how to be proud of my Christianity and not hide it. And she taught me how to shumayeza abafana bengihlela. That's the friend. That's the one. So when she moved away, yo, I felt so empty. It was so painful. That's why I don't like making too many friends, because ngingkwazi guys, yo ha, people grow and by venture into different places in Bilweni, so I cannot afford to be losing friends. And then the other one passed away the day after ngiqeda ukukhuluma naye, ngithi oh my gosh, ngizobona kusasa, bye, love you. And oh then my. The following day, ekuseni, supposed to meet esontweni, and then we get a call. She passed away. The whole service was so sour.
Was she ill?
She was ill. She would faint every now and then. Like, she had few complications, but none angam bulala at that age. Like, when 18, I think.
Oh, no.
If not younger. Yeah, I think a bit younger, or 18. So, ish. I miss her so much. I'll save you. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, yeah. I think for me, that was the most painful thing that I've ever experienced. I think I'm still going to experience more painful things, because I still have my full family. We don't have umuntu osashonile like ekhaya egcekeni, you know. So the thoughts nje freaks me out. But engasho ukuthi ngakufunda from that is that you never know when it's the last time umbona umuntu. Don't leave ningekho right.
Sure.
Trust me, you'd want to fix things on the spot. Even if you didn't learn it, but just try. Try something. But ungahambi usho something hurtful to umuntu owazi ukuthi uyamthanda.
Yeah.
And if they pass away, usuzele wena lolo bobuhlungu lobo ukuthi wagcina uthe. Imagine living that life nje of regret. So I think, yeah, it taught me to always show love, even if umuntu ungiphathe kabi and ngiyamthanda, but as ukuthi I still love you, but you really ungiphathe kabi, or whatever the case is, just you never know when it's the last time you ever see umuntu, so cherish every moment that you have with them.
You speak rather in that spirit of love and showing love. You sound like you're very close to your mom. You speak very fondly about your mom.
What did I say?
I can see it in your spirit. Even no. you were speaking about the how she was there for you when you auditioned, and she would help you. She'd play the other character. That's a person who's very close with their mom, or a mom is able to do that because she wants the best for you.
Yeah.
And she's present in being the mom who's going to be there for you as you try and pursue your life.
Yeah.
On that spirit of love, but you don't speak to me about your dad.
I do have a dad.
Is it? Okay.
I do have two parents. They're very lovely, Baba too.
Yeah.
But we see the thing with Ubaba, I konusko sambangimtand. How kawrata white. Now the thing is, my mom is a stay-at-home mom.
Okay.
Ne, she's a housewife.
So one nature is nantles na.
Yes, me nage, especially because by the time I was born, my mom, I think was a phone, and then why you phone at that time? Because imal was a problem. So. She's always here. Whereas Ubaba working good construction actors from your society for good
for
3 months,
months,
yeah. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of things because we some benzine or akekho like here at that time. So that's why I was going to go mano. I have both parents.
Yeah.
Very loving. They love me so much. I love them back. Yeah.
In a few years' time, God willingly, you'll have a daughter. What type of person, if your daughter sees this interview, because things on the internet live forever.
Yeah.
What type of person do you want your daughter to know you to be?
I've never thought of myself as a mom. First, let me think. Me, Imara. Okay. What type of a person do I want my daughter to see me or know me as?
Yeah.
I am, hi, my baby girl. If you're watching this video, that means that you have grown up so much that you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I want you to know that everything is going to happen. Yes, katsai. You don't have to rush life. You don't have to rush people.
Mm.
You don't have to rush anything.
Mm.
This life, it is an elu uti feverisha wena. When I was with you, things are supposed to follow after you. The Bible says goodness and mercy shall follow you. So I want you to know that if you ever feel rushed into anything, la also ukhona phuma lapho. Phuma lapho. Angeke size sifike endaweni ethize ngokufana asifani masabantu. So I just want you to know that it's okay to say no. It's okay to be different and not to live your life as how everybody else lives their life. I'm sure life is different for you now than it is for me now.
Yeah,
I'm talking to my daughter.
Yeah.
Nah. So just know yourself. Find yourself. Invest in knowing what you want, what you love about yourself or even about life itself. Don't like what everybody likes. And last but not least, don't change who you are. Because there's only one you in this entire universe. You cannot change you to find like another person. There's only one you. Remember that.
We're nearing the end of our conversation. Speak to me about what. There's a lot of challenges that young black females are going through at the moment. Mm. Alcoholism is a big one.
Yeah.
Amongst females, yeah. By the way. It's bigger in females than in males. People just don't want to account for that. And sure. As you're saying, it's that it could be attributed to a lot of the social ills that we are going through. Women are violated. Mm. Many women are violated. Asapatani kahle. We don't respect love anymore.
Yeah.
Even the lack of respect in the institution of marriage. Marriage, is it disrespect to umkhonyana wakhona? Iphindi disrespect to a side chick ya khona. Isho ngesifuba ukuthi mina indoda yakhe yone, you know.
Yeah.
There's so many things that are broken that we are trying to fix. I want to say this. Yes, I know you just spoke to your daughter, but the young black female now who's in her 20s, what things should they be prioritizing? And what things must they let go of? Because it's not taking them anywhere.
Yeah, ne?
Yeah.
I think to the young girls in their 20s, like me, so prioritize you. Prioritize investing in yourself, making yourself better in every way, in every aspect, in every department of life. Be it money-wise, prioritize uwenzi imali wena self, not ukuthi usuzomanje uzokompromise ngawe just to make that money. No, prioritize in having your own money, prioritize in your career. Prioritize your career, prioritize your family. Because one thing I can tell you, family comes first. And at the end of the day, when everybody is gone, you're going to be left with family.
Sure.
So you can have friends.
Yeah.
It's not a bad thing. But what I always say is, abangani, they can come and go. But once you find people that you create some relationships now that are so deep that it turns into sisterhood, keep it like that. Because when they are your sister, they can never go back.
You can fight all you're fighting. Yeah.
They'll always be your sister and they'll have your back. Don't hang around people that are not in like abanga improve impilo yakho, rather by a destroyer. A pastor of mine once said, "Show me your friends and I'll show you your future."
Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. That's it.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
It's been beautiful. As you said, it feels short.
Yeah.
But it was, which means you'll come back. And when you come back, you will be larger than life.
Okay, maybe you could have about three, but no, guys, the space is so quiet. I don't think I need to bring bodyguards. Not really.
The show is Engineer Your Life. I'm Lungelo KM. Yet another beautiful episode. I hope you felt the heart of Angel, Nomkhosi, to others. She's a very centered woman. She understands what she wants.
Yeah.
And she's building a life that is bigger for herself, but through God, right? Mm. She's very clear on that everything she does is through God and that she listens to the voice of God before she makes her decisions. Don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe. Please leave a comment and just say, "Wazwa muhle yellow bone," or something.
Please.
And don't forget to join as a member, because remember that if you join and if you subscribe, it grows the channel. And as the channel grows, it gives us access to give you bigger and better guests that you can learn from. I'll see you on the next episode.